Good morning kids. Today we are going to continue with polynomials and today's topic is geometrical meaning of the zeros of a polynomial. What actually we are going to learn in this topic? We are going to learn that by reading a graph only, how can we tell that how many zeros are there? Right? Finding the zeros of a polynomial from a graph. What you need to check in the graph so that you can understand how many zeros are there. What actually you need to check? You need to check that in how many points the graph intersects or touches x-axis. You need to check that in how many points the graph intersects or touches x-axis. If the graph intersects or touches x-axis at one point, then number of zeros is 1. If the graph intersects or touches x-axis at 2 points, the number of zeros are 2. If the graph intersects or touches x-axis at n points, the number of zeros are n. Well, n should be a whole number. It cannot happen. The graph is intersecting x-axis at 2.5 points. Whether it will intersect at 2 points or 3 points. Now, let's have a look of some graph of different kind of polynomial. In first case, you can see that the graph is intersecting here at x-axis at 1 point. So number of zeros is 1. This is the point where the graph is intersecting x-axis. Right? In second case, we can see the graph is intersecting here and touching here. Then total number of points are 1, 2 and 3. The total number of zeros equal to 3. In third case, you can see the graph is touching x-axis only at one point. The number of zeros is equal to 1. In fourth case, the graph is intersecting x-axis at 2 points. The number of zeros 2. In fifth case, the graph is not intersecting x-axis. Right? The graph is not intersecting x-axis, so total number of zeros will be 0. Here also, the graph is not intersecting x-axis, so total number of 0. Now here, we can observe that no graph is there, right? But, if you can observe carefully, you will see that the x-axis is little thicker than the y-axis. That means what? The graph is coinciding with x-axis, right? The graph is coinciding with x-axis. So that's why the total number of zeros are infinite. And this is called the zero polynomial graph. Now let's talk about linear polynomial. How can you identify a polynomial from a graph? Right? Some graphs are given to you. You have to understand that what kind of graph it is, whether it is a linear polynomial graph or a quadratic graph or a cubic graph, right? So how to check? So what about linear polynomial graph? The graph of a linear polynomial is a straight line and it cuts x-axis at most at one point. We already have done the graph of a linear polynomial last year. It will look something like this. Right? It could be a straight line and it will intersect x-axis at most one point. It may happen that it is not intersecting x-axis at all. Let's have a look of some different kind of linear polynomial graph. As you can see, in first case, this is a graph which is intersecting x-axis at minus 2. So minus 2 will be the zeros of that polynomial. In second case, the graph is intersecting x-axis at origin. So what more you can say about this graph? We can say that in this graph, x equal to y. When x is 0, y is 0. When x is 1, y is 1. When x is 2, y is 2. So we can say that it is x equal to y. When the graph crosses through origin, it's always x equal to y. Now, in third case, although it's a linear polynomial graph, but the number of zeros equal to 0. Because it is not intersecting x-axis at any point. Here, it is intersecting x-axis at one point, so number of zeros equal to 1. Here also, at one point, means at origin, number of zeros, 1. Here, it is not intersecting x-axis, so number of zeros equal to 0. Now, let's talk about quadratic polynomial. The graph of a quadratic polynomial is a parabola. Parabola means this is the shape is called parabola. It is open upwards and this is parabola open downwards. The graph of a quadratic polynomial is a parabola opening upwards, opening downwards and opening upwards. And it intersects or touches x-axis at most two points. And this graph of quadratic polynomial intersects x-axis at most two points. It may happen it is not touching at all. It may happen it is touching at only at one point. Let's try to understand why some graphs are opens downwards, why some graphs are open upwards, why some graphs are not touching x-axis, why they touch at one point. If the a is greater than 0, the parabola opens downward upwards, for example 2x square plus 5x plus 6. What I'm saying, if the a means, we all know that the quadratic polynomial general form is ax square plus bx plus c. A means what? The coefficient of x square. Now look here, what is the coefficient of x square? 2. A is greater than 0, means 2 is greater than 0. So that means the parabola will be open upwards. In second case, if A is less than 0, the parabola opens downwards. Now check here, what is A? A is minus 3. So it is less than 0, it is negative. A equal to minus 3, that is negative. So that means the parabola will be opens downwards, right? Third case, if discriminant D is greater than 0, the quadratic polynomial is having two zeros, hence the graph intersects x-axis at two points, for example x square minus 7x plus 10. If we find the discriminant of this x square minus 7x plus 10, we'll find that it is greater than 0. Let's find it. What is d? D equal to d square minus 4ac. So what is d here? D is minus 7. 4ac, 4 multiplied by a is 1 and c is 10. 49 minus 4p equal to 9. So d is coming 9, that means 9 is greater than 0. So that's why it will intersect the graph at two points like this. If d equal to 0, the quadratic polynomial is having one zero, hence the graph touches x-axis at one point, for example x square minus 6x plus 9. If we find the d of this, means discriminant of this, we'll find it is coming 0, d equal to 0. So the graph will be something like this. It will touch x-axis at 1 point. Now in next is, if d is less than 0, the quadratic polynomial is having no real zeros, hence the graph will not intersect or touch x-axis. For example, x square plus 5x plus 7. If we'll find the discriminant of this, we'll find it is coming in negative. D will be in negative. So the graph will be something like this. It will not touch x-axis. It will not intersect. It will not touch. Let's have a look of some different kind of quadratic polynomial graph. In first case, you can see that first thing, it is a parabola opens upwards. This is also parabola opens upwards. This is also parabola opens upwards. So all these three, this one, and this one, are the example of where A is greater than 0. Where A is greater than 0. In all the three cases, since it is parabola opens upwards, that means A is greater than 0. All these three cases, the A is greater than 0. Now here, in these three cases, we can observe that the parabola opens downwards. That means in all these three cases, A will be less than 0. Means A is negative. Here A is positive. Got it? Now, in this case and this case, we can observe that graph is intersecting x-axis at two points. Right? Graph is intersecting x-axis at two points. That means what? Here D is greater than 0. In both the cases, D is greater than 0. In both the cases, D is greater than 0. In these two cases, we can observe that graph is intersecting x-axis at only one point. That means what? D equal to 0. In these two cases, D equal to 0. Since the graph is intersecting x-axis at only one point, so that means D is equal to 0, because it is having, this polynomial is having only one 0. In next two cases, we can observe that graph is not intersecting at all. That means D is less than 0. D is negative. That's why the graph is not intersecting x-axis. Here D is positive. So in all these three cases, we can observe that graph is parabola opens upwards. That means A is negative. A means the coefficient of x squared, the leading of coefficient, we can say. Here, in all these three cases, the graph is opens downwards. That means A means the coefficient of x squared is less than 0. That means A is negative. In these two cases, the graph is intersecting x-axis at two points. That means D is greater than 0, means D is positive. These two cases, the graph is intersecting, not intersecting, it is touching x-axis at one point. So that means D equal to 0. And in these two cases, graph is not intersecting x-axis. That means D is less than 0. And that's why D is negative. D means discriminant. And what is the formula of D? D equal to B square minus 4AC. That's why I explained the concept of quadratic formula that way, so that you can understand why these graphs are not intersecting, not touching. Now, coming to cubic polynomial, it doesn't have a fixed shape and the graph intersects or touches x-axis at most three points. Right? A cubic polynomial graph, they don't have a fixed shape and it intersects or touches x-axis at most three points. It may happen it is intersecting at one point only, or two points only, or in three points. Here are some pictures of a cubic polynomial graph. As you can see, the graph, although it's a cubic polynomial, but graph is intersecting x-axis at only one point. So number of zeros equal to zero. In next case, it's a cubic polynomial and it is touching, intersecting x-axis at three different points, 1, 2, and 3. So number of zeros equal to 3. It doesn't have a fixed shape like a quadratic polynomial. Now this is your first exercise, exercise 2.1. And now I believe that you can find the number of zeros very easily here. Now in first case, let's have a look in how many points the graph is intersecting x-axis. In how many points? No points, the number of zeros equal to zero. Here, the graph is intersecting x-axis only at one point, so number of zeros, one. Here, the graph is intersecting x-axis at 1, 2, and 3 points, so number of zeros, 3. Here, the graph is intersecting x-axis at 2 points, so number of zeros equal to 2. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, number of zeros, 4, 1, 2, 3. So number of zeros is equal to 3. Let's have a look. And this is all about exercise 2.1. In next class, we are going to start exercise 2.2. And the concept is the relationship between the zeros of a polynomial and their coefficients. Thank you.